up for recharge. Stopped by Marcel Cronenberg. It's Cooper. Flicking it down the ice and over the blue line. 3 seconds. Two. One. The game is over. The Toronto Maple Leafs have won the Stanley Cup.
Well done, Toronto. You've reached Talkie's El Dorado. The glories of the Stanley Cup. With expansion on the horizon, great challenges are sure to arise. Regardless, the future should be just as bright. It will not be the season afterwards, as the Maple Leafs are victimized by a stacked Eastern Conference. They will have no chance to defend their title. They manage to make it to the playoffs the next year. Just as they enter the door, they are promptly swept aside by the brooms of Boston. Team owners Harold Ballard and Stafford Smythe are being charged with tax evasion, a dastardly crime. Their usage of team funds for personal gain gives them a nice ticket ride to the Slammer. You seriously needed more money? You guys sold your two farm teams and used the cup banners to catch paint drippings, for God's sake. They deliver something special to your doorstep. Another year without a postseason. Toronto promptly reorders and gets a first-round defeat at the hands of the Rangers. They won games this time, though. Newsflash, Toronto! After a rigorous power struggle and Stafford Smythe conveniently dying, you have a new majority owner. A man deep in the bowels of prison. Meet your new master, Harold Ballard. The Leafs celebrate as they are blown away by the industrial strength fan known as the Bruins. These damn players always want more and more money for doing the same damn thing. Don't they know that's going to hurt the bottom line? The WHA isn't going to do anything to us. Please, go there. You'll come crawling back. A good deal of young depth happens to jump at the opportunity. One of these players happens to be a goaltender named Bernie Perron. Still worth the increased profit. Who the hell knew that shedding that much talent would cost a team a shot at the playoffs? Shocking. You know what else is? More players fleeing for the WHA. Try Paul Henderson, the hero of the 72 Summit series. He's gone. Harold Ballard is a massive xenophobe, but he's still serving time in jail for fraud. Quickly, let's sign one of the soft Europeans he hates in Boya Selmig. He'd only turn into one of the best players on the Leafs. Nothing that crazy. They get to have their asses swept by the Bruins yet again. What a rivalry. The reward is getting stomped and swept by the Philadelphia Flyers. They're led in net by a former Leaf in Bernie Perron. So, we still win, right? Dave Keough. What a piece of shit. This guy has the balls to demand more money from us. And for what? Being the captain? Fuck him, he leads as well as my flaccid penis into a broad. Go, leave for the WHA, Dave. We'll repeatedly screw you with a lead pipe every time you want to come back to the NHL. Fitting for a Judas. Harold Ballard is so confident in his team. They will beat the Flyers in a playoff series. All the pyramid power and other schemes leads to being bitch-slapped 4 times in Philadelphia. Think of the playoff revenue, though. The last series loss was so sweet they lose to the Flyers again. In 6 games. The Leafs go on to make the conference finals, their greatest season in a decade. Sadly, those francophones in Montreal won another cup as well. That sucking sound is that of sweeping. Bob Davidson, the father of modern scouting. That old fogey thinks he's so hot since he was a former Leaf in the 40s. You know what else was popular back then? Polio. Too goddamn expensive for that. How about a mandatory cut in your salary by 2/3, Bob? What, you have bills to pay? Too bad you can leave. Who the fuck needs scouting? New Age Mumbo Jumbo is more like it. Ballard is not happy. That damn hippie Roger Nielsen is ruining the culture of this fine team. He doesn't embrace our country club atmosphere. I don't care if it's on live television and he led the team to the conference finals last year. I want the world to know. Roger, get the fuck out! Roger, buddy! Look, we didn't mean anything serious when we fired you on TV. It's just the typical hazing. You get that right? We want you back behind the bench. The only thing we're gonna ask of you is that you just put this paper bag over your head and be labeled as the mystery couch. We all win. You won't do it. Fuck. So he got swept by Les Canadiens again. Roger, here's a security detail to throw you out. And take that paper bag with you. The NHL is bringing in those fucking refugees from the WHA. They ruined everything. They took our players. They inflated salaries to where Ballard's having fewer steak dinners than he did in prison. We're losing TV revenues from expansion. Dave Keon is back in the league. The NHL will rue this day. Players nowadays are too goddamn soft and entitled. They need a nice punch in the gut. See what I did there? Punch him, Lack. The cup-winning coach is our new GM. That old GM Jim Gregory, he'll find out he's out of a job eventually. They all do. The quest for more money is an arduous one. Luxury suites are the wave of the future. Think of how much coin we could make with those beauties in our arena. There's only one thing standing in our way of this glorious profit. Foster Hewitt Scandella, an ancient relic of a time that is irrelevant in the art of finance. We don't care that the NHL wants to buy it off of us, why should we glorify the past? Perhaps they should have thought of that when they betrayed us for the WHA's traitorous ways. Shove it into the incinerator! Daryl Sittler has conjured too much power. He's infecting the rest of the team with these plagues of players, unions, and leadership. Like we want that cancer infesting the team. The failure that gave him a no-trade clause shall die, but we can undermine him. We'll start with his good friend Lanny McDonald. He'll get a one-way ticket to the Mickey Mouse organization. The Colorado Rockies. Oh, the players don't like us trading Lanny. Well, fuck them. Sittler can rot in hell for ripping off the sea. Might as well burn the Canadian flag while you're at it. I think it's time for a good old-fashioned purge of the old guard. Thin out the dissenters a little. Our flags are promptly burned in a sweep by... North Stars? Minnesota? Punch him like had a heart attack. That means someone needs to step up to take the mantle. Toronto, meet your acting GM, Harold Ballard. Toronto needs to know who the real heroes are. The rift between Sittler and Ballard is allegedly amended while we wait to stab him in the back. The real issue is with that asshole Alan Eagleson. Corrupting poor Daryl with thoughts of unions, no one can resist. Be swept yet again by the New York Islanders. Sounds like a trend. Punch Imlach, while recovering from his forced vacation, suffered another heart attack. He's too unreliable, so we can also eventually find out he's lost his job when he tries to come back to work. We'll bring in a guy who alleges he has brain damage. A solid choice as GM. We have broken him. Daryl Sittler has been beaten to the point where he's walked out on the team. This is a decisive victory for Toronto. May we celebrate by raising ticket prices again. The final solution to the Sittler question has been reached. The Flyers are so nice they'll remove this tumor from our body for pennies on the dollar. Those pennies are perfect for Ballard's coffers. Leafs fans, welcome to hell. Lori Boschman has grown soft. He's been corrupted by Sittler and is a blight upon our organization. The man's become a born-again Christian! We can't have that negative influence on our team! Edmonton can deal with the Crusades later. They still don't win a playoff game. They don't even make it to them. They can just catch those morsels from the team above, like the leaky roof of Maple Leaf Gardens. Plastic helps with that. Toronto won a playoff game this time, but they lose 3-0 to Minnesota again. You like those cup banners of years past, you'd be alone. We like money, so we sold them off to a random buyer. It can help us add more seats if we wanted. The Leafs are horrible. No playoffs again. Harold Ballard is increasingly cheap on the team as they only employ 3 full-time scouts and run a bare-bones operation. Prospects are drafted by Canadian-ness and rushed to the NHL to sink or swim. They are a black eye on the league. 0 fucks were given as money was made. Enjoy being the worst team in hockey. Utter shit, and Ballard doesn't seem keen on dying anytime soon. Why should he put out a better team? That goes against basic economics! Every game is a sellout, you know? That would only cut into the profit margins. If you were in his shoes, you'd understand his struggle. Here's a young Wendell Clark to become your catnip for an eternity. What's that, Rick 5, Mr. Practice? Strip him of the captaincy! That ought to make him regret that treachery! Toronto makes the playoffs because Detroit channeled a rear-ended Pinto. They somehow sweep the Blackhawks and nearly clip the Blues before losing in 7. Ballard is sitting back counting the money from playoff receipts. Good news, Ballard's wallet! The Leafs barely made the playoffs thanks to a tiebreaker. Even better news, they beat the Blues in a series and have a 3-1 series lead against the Red Wings. That's where the news stops. Everyone is dead after blowing the series to Detroit. Who cares, Ballard's doing a Scrooge McDuck impression. Just with more public battles with his kids and ex-wives. They made the playoffs as the second worst team in hockey. They get bitch slapped around by the Red Wings again. Thank the Lord for postseason ticket revenues. Russ Courtnall is a pretty good player, but we need more Canadian toughness to really get Ballard's engine running. I got it. Goon. John Kordick from Montreal. That's awfully nice of those French bastards to get softer. New GM Gord Stellick is a fucking asshole. Bastard keeps drinking all the coffee, you know how much that costs? John Brophy had the team in first place, but they've stumbled. That means a good old-fashioned firing. Look at George Armstrong. He was a winner in 1967. He will be this team's next head coach. Only thing is he doesn't want to coach and has the assistant do everything. Just don't tell Harold about it. They are shockingly still terrible, but this time there are no playoffs for the Leafs. Troy Murray in overtime will see to that. Try again next eternity. Unfortunately, Harold Ballard is somehow still alive. and is now firing the guy who pushes his wheelchair. You'll forever remember his name. His hand and footprints are underneath center ice for eternity. Lanny McDonald finally gets revenge after his exile. He goes out in a blaze of glory with the Calgary Flames. See that, Toronto? It's called the Stanley Cup. Boya Salming is tired of all the losing and terrible Leafs teams. He decides to leave and sign with Detroit. God, what a heathen. Signing with an inferior American team. Gord Stellick resigns from the Maple Leafs due to continued meddling from Harold Ballard. The cockroach never dies. The Maple Leafs may simply be treading water and have no real hope for the short-term future, but we can smell the cup run in the distance. Toronto needs a top-flight defenseman that can lead the way in the future. Let's trade a first-round pick in a few years for Tom Kervers. He might be a filthy American, but we can make an exception here. The series with St. Louis continues with Ernest, but something tells me good news is afoot. What's this, a message for us? It says, oh my God, it's a miracle!
Congratulations, Harold Ballard is finally dead!
His death galvanizes the team to lose the final game of the series to the Blues the very next day. It's just what he'd want. Selling out for the good old Canadian dollar. So it turns out Tom Kervers is truly a worthless American. New Jersey gave us a false bag of goods. Let's just cut our losses and trade him to Vancouver for Brian Bradley. They always like trash. Well, everything fell to shit. The Maple Leafs are suffering for the sins of cheapness from the Ballard years. The talent level is terrible. Constant losing abound, but there is a silver lining. Eric Lindros is in this draft. If we suck enough, we can bring him home and save this team. Ooh, another message for us. Good news indeed. It says that this is the pick we traded for Tom Kervers. Well, this sucks. Okay, we fixed the problem. We had to trade several futures, including the 6th overall pick a few years ago to Quebec for anti-tanking veteran players, but we didn't give up Lindros. Everything's going to be fine. What, you're worried about this Scott Niedermeyer guy New Jersey drafted? He's going to be nothing. He's a bum. He's from the wrong side of Canada. Trust me, there is absolutely no way that this trade is going to haunt the Leafs in the future. Like this softy's gonna do anything in the NHL. Calgary is full of idiots, you know that? They gave us a franchise center and Doug Gilmore for a bunch of flotsam and jetsam. Their fucking him over is our gain for once. These inbreds don't even know who Alex Galchenyuk even is and they still traded for him. Toronto is coming back, baby! There's also no playoffs for the Leafs this year, but who gives a fuck anymore? We have a logjam at center now, so we can afford to lose a guy or two in the expansion draft. We have some scrubs here, but Brian Bradley is obsolete in the age of Gilmore. He is taken by the Tampa Bay Lightning. Therefore, as a result of the Tom Kervers trade...
You get nothing! You lose! Good day, sir!
Brian Bradley immediately becomes the first great face of the Lightning franchise. I don't know, you might have been able to use him. It's finally over. The years of failure, of futility, of totalitarian cheapness washed away. The Maple Leafs are a legitimate playoff contender again. Impressive victories against old foes like the Red Wings and Blues in 7 games apiece have this team gunning for their first cup finals in over 25 years. It's a chippy, intense series against the Kings. Players ready to kill each other, coaches ready to kill each other, a true barn burner. Game 6 is the moment for the Leafs to emerge. Watch as Wendell Clark becomes the great hero this city needs, tying the game to head to overtime with the Leafs on the attack. Even Dougie Gilmore knows that. You aren't gonna call that? You missed it due to the Gretzky handicap? This is the part where Toronto bitches, isn't it?
Zazzle takes the puck away from Robitaille. Robitaille gets it back center! They score! Gretzky scores!
From this point forward, fans of the Maple Leafs in Toronto in general will use this game as infinite fuel for their perpetual victim complex. The name Carey Fraser forever reviled due to his treachery against an honorable team. Some dare say that the NHL was conspiring against the Leafs to prevent an all-Canadian Stanley Cup final, even though the real reason is that the officials simply suck. Even then, there's still another chance. They're headed back home to take on the Kings in game 7. Oh, they never mentioned that part, did they? That's because the Great One does what he did throughout the 80s and utterly dominates the Maple Leafs on their home ice. The whole game plays out like a funeral for the city of Toronto. There is only cold-blooded murder of all hope eternally until the end of life itself. Keep saying the officials fucked you. It's totally the reason why a goal went off Dave Ellett's skate. The Leafs make another deep run to the conference finals after ending the Sharks' foolish ambitions, but are whipped by the speed of their inferior Western counterparts in the Canucks in 5 games. Unfortunately, there are no officials to blame this time, only themselves. This is easily the worst scandal in the history of the Maple Leafs. Wendell Clark, a good old Canadian boy, was traded! Everyone needs to be fired now! Who the fuck is Matt Sundin? The Leafs efficiently blow a 2-0 series lead over the Blackhawks. They blow a 3-goal lead in Game 6 at home, but Randy Wood bails out the Leafs from certain disaster. It merely delays the inevitable ass-kicking and scalping to come in Game 7. We can smell the Cup Finals in our midst. All the Leafs need are more premium pieces to bolster the defensive core. Let's get ourselves a true veteran keystone in Larry Murphy! Pat Burns has been one of the best coaches in Toronto's history, but the team is struggling immensely. The Maple Leafs have never been good at this whole PR thing, so why not fire him to incite the fanbase to riot? That always works. Shit, the fanbase is still pissed at us for firing Pat Burns.
Ooh, I've got it!
You kids remember Uncle Wendell? He's back! The Leafs are laid to pasture by the Blues in 6 games. And not just any Blues squad, this is to Mike Keenan's Blues. You know, the one where he gutted everything to bring back a bunch of 80s Oilers and early 90s Blackhawks players? Nostalgia is a bitch, you know? Don't worry, Nick Kiprios will make a run on Der Fuhrer and quietly sabotage their playoff hopes. They were thinking long-range game. So Wayne Gretzky is interested in finishing the final years of his career in Toronto. Yeah, it may be nice to give our fans PTSD of 1993, but seriously? What's the financial incentive to bringing him here? We already sell out games. Why spend more money than we need? If you thought the Ballard era couldn't get any worse, try an underground sex ring in Maple Leaf Gardens in the 80s involving dozens of underage boys. Knowing Harold, I'm more surprised he didn't find a way to sell tickets to it. Larry Murphy is far more of a scandal than the sex ring. He is a cancer that's destroying the team fabric from within. He isn't even worthy of trying to fetch a good return for. Detroit, you want him? Here, take him! Just take him! We'll even eat the majority of his salary remaining on his contract! Just get his ass the fuck out of here! How's that for a Murphy dump? Larry Murphy is such a malignant cancer that he proceeds to be a key contributor on back-to-back Stanley Cup winners. Maybe he wasn't the true problem in Toronto. Despite expectations, the Leafs fall apart and miss the playoffs thanks to an aging core and poor transactions. It may be time for a rebuild, but at least we'll get a high draft pick for the failure. Another message. Well, it appears we traded this pick to get Wendell Clark back.
By God, it's like we never learn.
Toronto's 4th overall pick in this draft is used to select Roberto Luongo. If there's any solace, the Islanders completely fuck this one up as well. Shit again. No playoffs. At least you'll get to move to the Eastern Conference to limit air travel. Felix the Cat needs to be put to sleep. He's not going to bring us to the level we need, not like Cujo will do. All things seem aligned to go back to the Cup Finals in this frontier, only to be dominated by the Sabres in 5 games. We're losing to Buffalo now? Wendell Clark may be a hollow shell of what he was, but he's back in a Leafs uniform yet again. Yay? His Canadian grit canade our budding defenseman and Brian Berard. Oh, so now you call a penalty! Fuck you, officials! And fuck you, Ottawa, for ruining Berard's career! It's a new age for the Leafs. The sins of the past are being forgiven. The Maple Leaf Gardens are being replaced by a new arena. The NHL has given the team new cup banners for the occasion. Just look at this 100-point season. Beautiful, ain't it? They even got to beat Ottawa in the so-called Battle of Ontario. Fuck you, Marian Hossa. The next door is revealed to be a trap by the Devils. It happens to a lot of teams. Shut up and deal with it. The Leafs have a 5-0 lead against the St. Louis Blues with 15 minutes left in the game. Fantastic stuff. Would you be shocked to find out that they blew said lead to lose in overtime? Not really. Well, it is Toronto. Expectations are pretty low around here. The Leafs sneak into the playoffs to allow the world to laugh at the Senators again. Their prize is being crushed under the iron boot of New Jersey yet again. With a 3-2 series lead. The key is to get older. Much older. Make it so, Toronto.
Here's a chance at the line.
The most glorious goal in Leafs history on home ice since the Cup win. Who knows what the possibilities are if they get back to the Stanley Cup Finals? Only few can imagine the potential of such an event. They are serenaded by the Brass Bonanza. Look what we brought back for the playoff push, Toronto! The return of Dougie Gilmore! The gods won't let Toronto have any joy, will they? If that means getting obliterated by the Flyers in a Game 7, then yes, that means there will be no optimism whatsoever. Even Shane Corson saw through this shit and walked out on the team. The rest took his lead, apparently. You know, the whole point of a battle is for it to be evenly matched, Ottawa. Too bad they didn't think the same thing would happen against Philadelphia yet again. Even with Ronnie Franchise and Brian Leetch, there will be no success. Hopefully it won't be a while until you win a playoff series again. We brought him home. Eric Lindros is finally a Leaf. It may be about 15 years too late, but we don't care about that. Lead us to the playoffs, Eric. He fails. There will be no postseason in Leafland. Eliminated by being 2 points away from a spot. Maybe going 3-8-2 in the month of January wasn't the best thing for you. Our team may be aging, but Andrew Raycroft is a goalie on the rise. You may see a player who was a flash in the pan and is about to be waived by Boston, but they're wrong. We love him so much that we'll trade our former first-round pick for him. If he flops, who cares? We have Justin Pogge. We'll be fine. I forgot to mention that prospect they ended up trading for Raycroft. His name just happened to be Tuukka Rask. You can be haunted by that name for years as Justin Pogge doesn't develop whatsoever. Sorry, I don't make the rules here. There are significant strides made in the playoff push. You only missed the playoffs by 1 point this time. Progress is progress, am I right? It's all good, we'll bolster this team in the offseason. So we traded our first 2 picks in this draft for Mark Bell and Vesa Toskala. It won't haunt us. The first round pick they traded turned into Lars Eller. Not bad, you say. Well, San Jose would take the 2 picks Toronto traded them to move up and select Logan Couture. Failure by proxy. A 40-goal scorer on the wrong side of 30? That's perfect! Jason Blake might fall off after a career year, but we're willing to take that risk. For a shitload of money. Jason Blake is struck down by a treatable form of leukemia. He keeps on playing, though. That's very admirable of him. Yuri Talusti can learn a thing or two from that, what with him putting nudes of himself on the internet. Perhaps he can wallow in shame as the team finishes 11 points out of a playoff spot. In the meantime, everyone just shits on Brian McKay. So much for improvement. We brought back Cliff Fletcher, so he knows the score. Jeff Finger had himself a really nice year on the third pairing in Colorado. He may be in his late 20s with serious potential of being a one-year wonder, but it's nothing that the Leafs can sign him for. What? So that Jeff Finger guy we grossly overpaid and is being buried in the AHL now? Yeah, turns out we may have been thinking about Kurt Sauer. Why we'd want either of them nowadays, who the hell knows? Cliff Fletcher is too old for bringing the Leafs into the modern age. But you know who will? Brian Burke is our president and GM. He's going to fill this team with so many good old North American boys your head will spin. Matt Sundin didn't sign with us because of wear and tear on his body, but he wants to come back now. So what the hell does he do? Sign with our inferior cross-country counterpart in Vancouver. He's dead to us. Make a trade for Ole the goalie, because surely your goaltending is the problem.
This is bouncing into the net!
It probably is. There will only be pain from this point forward, if that's even possible. Another year without playoffs. Harold Ballard would have had people killed for all these years without those extra revenues. If at first you don't succeed, keep bashing your head against the wall until you break through. It's how Mike Komisarek treats opposing forwards. How about a handsome little contract for our budding shutdown defenseman? Komisarek meets a wall he cannot break. It's called physical decline. An injury-riddled flop. What the Leafs need is a great North American superstar. We know just the man. Phil Kessel, the American dream. He will snipe his way into the heart of every Maple Leaf fan. Let us begin this new age of Leaf dominance. Thanks for the franchise player, Boston. Kessel is a good piece, but what about the back end? How about a hard-hitting Canadian boy with the talents to lead an elite core? You know the name, Dion Phaneuf. It's just like fleecing Calgary for Gilmore again. Those fuckers don't know talent like we do. How about we get jiggy with it for good measure? Perfection. Berkey Boy's North American dream team couldn't get them above dead last in the Eastern Conference. A total disaster of a season that can't get much worse than it already has. Oh god, now what? We traded our first 2 picks in this draft for Kessel? Fucking god! The second overall pick in this draft is used by Boston to select Tyler Seguin, a player who is at least equal to Kessel's talents at a far more valuable position. It's not a game-breaker, though. He wouldn't have fit in with the pristine culture that we're building up in Toronto. Fans are so frustrated with our glorious vision that waffles are thrown onto the ice. Should have thrown hot dogs, but can't predict the future. Anaheim really wants Francois Beauchemin? Here, have him like we want that French sissy. We'll take Joffrey Lupul and Jake Gardner off your hands, sure! The new core is beginning to develop. We finished 10th in the conference. At least it's something. Let me guess, we traded our first this year in the Kessel trade? Yep. Boston uses their selection this time to pick Dougie Hamilton. He'd look nice in the blue line, but once again he would have been abrasive due to his personality. Who the fuck willingly calls himself Dougie? Toronto may not have their first round pick this year, but we can see the future of our team. Tyler Biggs, a tough, gritty, blue-collar North American boy worthy of donning the Leaf. You may see a player with a low floor and bottom six potential, but for us, it's worthy of trading a hefty price to move up and select him. Tyler Biggs evolves into a fringe player who can't crack a roster. In the AHL, a total bust who doesn't even sniff the show. I mean, it sucks, but come on, the picks we traded to Anaheim only turned into Ricard Raquel! And John Gibson. Did I say it gets worse? Because it does. Several years earlier, the Leafs traded for Wayne Primeau in a second-round pick from Calgary in this draft. Toronto would then use this pick to help get their 2010 second-round pick back from Chicago to trade for Kessel. The pick traded to the Blackhawks would end up becoming Brendan Saad. I am not making this up. This is the year, boys. I can feel it. You start out the season winning 7 of your first 10 games and have the lead in your division. The 18-wheeler is rolling right along. The 18-wheeler proceeds to drive right off a cliff. An incredible collapse is their reward for the strong start. They lose 10 of 11 and fire Ron Wilson out of a cannon. Berkey boy brings in his buddy from Anaheim and Randy Carlyle. That always goes well. The free fall doesn't stop and they miss the playoffs again. You managed to keep your first round pick, shockingly. It was used to pick Morgan Riley. That's at least something. The next lockout is ending, so what better way to make things more confusing than to shake up the management core right before the season starts? Brian Burke's dream is nothing more than a pyramid scheme. You like fighting people in barns, Berkey boy? Good, because we're gonna chuck you in a death pit for no reason. Enjoy your stay. The Leafs have finally made the playoffs again. Perhaps miracles can happen after all. It's too bad they're going up against Boston, and they have a 3-1 series lead. Well, at least they're here. Wait, you're not bending the knee? You're doing it, boys! You're fucking doing it! It's happening!
My lord! A glorious victory will soon be yours!
It's beautiful. The first series win in almost a decade. I can smell it from here. A little waft of shit, but relax, Toronto. There's still plenty of time, but you're up by 2. You won't fuck this up. Right? Really? You're gonna pull this shit again? At least find a way to blame the refs for this or something. I swear, if you blow this... You people are fucking pathetic, you know that? I'm not even going to pretend there's a chance in hell for you to win, you're gonna blow it. Let's not waste any more time with this trash. Just play the clip! Put us all out of our fucking misery! And this is why you can't have nice things, Toronto.
You blew it!
Same fucking thing!
It appears we need players who don't choke in the playoffs now. How about Dave Boland? Look at how clutch he is against Boston. It's perfection. All we had to do was trade 3 mid-round picks to get him. We will prevail. Trust us. You might still be broken from the devastating loss to Boston, but we have a nice gift for you. David, no. Wendell Clarkson. The great power forward of the future. You may see a one-year wonder with huge risks attached, but we see the glories of-
The narrator has malfunctioned as a result of this contract. Stand by for immediate resuscitation.
Phil Kessel may be a player who can't be the face of a franchise, but that doesn't mean we can't pay him like one. He can have himself an 8-year extension at an exorbitant payday. A wise investment. Locking up this core that can't carry a team is important, and that includes Dion Phaneuf. He gets a lengthy extension as well. We're set for a good future of tire spinning. Let's take a look at how well Dave Nonis has built the Leafs. Dave Boland is an injury-riddled mess that's gone at the end of the year. Captain Dion is on a slow decline. Phil the Thrill just puts up points and nothing else. And David Clarkson. Oh, to say his contract has been a disaster is a gross understatement. He was earning about $500,000 for every point he had this year. Wonderful. The team resembles his play as they lose 12 of their last 14 games to crumble like a graham cracker. No revenge for last year's choke. Nonis has been a travesty at the helm. We need a fresh start. Brendan Shanahan has dropped the gavel of discipline to become the new president of the Leafs organization. The time for half measures and careless spending is over. They need to strip everything down and completely rebuild this team's awful foundations. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Shanaplan. Is an idiot desperate enough to take the Clarkson contract off our hands? Thank the Lord Columbus didn't have insurance for Nathan Horton's contract. We'll eagerly swallow that awful deal. As long as we don't have to deal with Wendell Clarkson anymore. Wendell Clarkson. Don't insult our god like that. The team is completely awful. Rock bottom occurs when they are obliterated by Nashville 9-2 on home ice. They're locked into awful contracts in Kessel and Phaneuf as they have proven they aren't franchise-changing talents. The team is fucked. Everyone is miserable. A blow-up is imminent. Enjoy dying alone and unloved. Randy Carlyle is garbage. We all knew this. To develop the team properly, we need the best. And that man's name is Mike Babcock. How about a King's Ransom to coach the Leafs back to glory, Mike? Babcock must be saved. Phil Kessel is the true cancer on this team. Look at him, eating hot dogs on his way to the stadium. That fat tub of blood is robbing us blind. The Penguins want this living tumor on the team? Fine, have him. We'll take some futures for the trouble. Like clockwork, Phil Kessel immediately becomes a fan favorite in Pittsburgh and key contributor to back-to-back Stanley Cup winners. Does that sound familiar? The Leafs finally convinced Dave Keon to end his 40-year feud with the team and mends a broken bridge. It's admirable to pursue such redemption. Ballard is seething in hell during the ceremonies. Hold on, someone actually acquired Dion Phaneuf's awful contract? And Toronto didn't have to retain any salary in the process? The Maple Leafs continue to win the Battle of Ontario. Have fun with his declining abilities, Ottawa. Bring out the tanks, boys. It's time to go deep diving for a top draft pick. Don't bother with the bad season. It's honestly for the best. The failure sprouts a nice reward by Toronto winning the draft lottery. The Maple Leafs select a new franchise center in Austin Matthews. Amazing what things can happen when you keep your first round picks. Robita Island is where we send our broken hockey players to rot until their sentence is up. Joffrey Lupul decided it would be a great idea to keep getting injured, so... buddy? The next boat is waiting to send you to exile. Be a good chap and sit there for a bit. Toronto surprisingly makes the postseason ahead of schedule as a young, hungry team. Impressive enough, but they give the top flight Capitals more than their share. Even though they lose the series in 6 games, there is hope again. It's more than can be said over the last 10 or so years. We will learn from the mistakes of our past ancestors. No throwing money at aging talents in free agency. We chucked over $6 million per year at a declining Patrick Marleau? What happened to why spending? The Leafs emerge as a legitimate contender. The dreams are back on for a team once maligned as terrible. The skill and talent in their forward core has given Toronto a new age of hockey. Their longtime enemy in Boston is the perfect adversary. Nazem Kadri is ready, as long as he's in the lineup. Feeling like repeat performances, Toronto goes flat and has another 3-1 series deficit. Deja vu. Also like 2013, there's an unsung hero for the Leafs. Danish wunderkind Frederik Andersen. Like a certain Reimer fellow, he near single-handedly backstops Toronto back into the series. Game 7 at TD Garden. The ultimate boogeyman is in their sights. Deja vu? It's happening again. The Toronto magic. All I can feel is hope about. The Leafs are leading the Bruins heading into the third period. This doesn't feel like 4-1. This is a different team. You just had to turn into a pumpkin when it truly mattered again, didn't you? Narratives are restored as Andersen runs out of gas and the Maple Leafs are knocked out in brutal fashion. Agony repeated. Way to waste an outstanding effort by Freddy. The crushing defeat to Boston proves that Toronto needs more. They make an incredibly bold and brash move to start free agency. The big fish is John Tavares. He's a local boy who adored the Leafs growing up. Just look at those pajamas. The contract may be steep and could have huge implications on their team in the future, but fuck it. The time is now. Isles fans can be salty as hell. The Leaf will rise again. The youngins need to start getting paid. That includes William Nylander. He's holding out for a nice contract, so it shouldn't hurt to pay him what he wants. A little under $7 million per year, we can manage. The price won't be paid until further down the road. Speaking of which, Austin Matthews is due his big boy contract. The price will be steep, but such talent is worthy of payment. $11.6 million per year for 5 years. That's a little steeper than we had hoped. Toronto finally has expectations. They have significant flaws but are considered to be a serious cup contender. Not even Nazem Kadri trying to kill someone again can stop it. Hell, the Leafs have a 3-2 series lead against Boston going back to home ice. This is their chance to slay their eternal demons. Revenge is in sight. It's a repeat of Game 7 in 1993. They lay an egg on home ice as Tuukka Rask torments you with visions of Andrew Raycroft again. Thus leads to another death march. Game 7 at TD Garden. The Groundhog Day prophecy is fulfilled. The Leafs fan base is once again broken. The Bruins proceed to stomp their bitch in front of a rabid Boston faithful in a series-clinching game. Again!
Watch this, Leafs. You can actually pinpoint the second when his heart rips in half. And now!
Your longtime brothers in failure in St. Louis finally shed their demons. They win the Stanley Cup, thus making the Leafs the team with the longest cup drought in hockey. They also win with former Leafs like Alex Steen, Carl Gunnarsson, and Tyler Bozak making a significant impact. Does it feel cold? You should have known this for a while now. We're bringing him back home. David Clarkson, now merely a resident of Robida Island due to injuries. Can we even call this a homecoming? Mitch Marner is the great dilemma of our times. To pay him or not to pay him. He wants a massive deal. It may fuck us dearly in the future, but let's roll the dice. We gave him Matthews money? We've invested over $40 million in cap space to four players. How are we going to afford a defense or a backup goalie in the future? We've already lost Nazem Kadri and Jake Gardner due to the cap. Oh dear God. The Leafs finally realize that Mike Babcock is, in reality, a dinosaur that is holding the team back. They kick his backside out the door like he allegedly kicked his players. We still got this, right? You weren't fond of just losing to backup goaltenders, but you lose to a 42-year-old Zamboni driver. On your home ice. After both Hurricanes goalies were injured. And you employ said Zamboni driver. Trying year. From the pylon of Cody Ceci to the vanishing act of the offensive core to experiencing the horrors of Michael Hutchinson. They try both everything and nothing to fix the issues, but they keep flaring up time and time again. Even then, it's all good. Deep breath. The pandemic has made the playoffs into a total crapshoot. You can wipe the floor with Columbus with absolutely no problem.
Every time, man. Every goddamn time! What deal did Ballard make for you to deserve this?
The Muzzin injury isn't hurting you, thank God. You have a 3-goal lead heading into the third period. The series lead is all but yours. Oh, so you blew the lead in the final period to lose the game in overtime? Are you seriously this pathetic? How in God's name does a team that looks great one moment turn into goop within 20 minutes? At least the series isn't over yet. Well, now it pretty much is. Down by 3 with 4 minutes left to go. I see you've learned absolutely nothing over the years. Just fold it up, you aren't worthy of my time. Wait a minute, you came back in amazing fashion to win the game? Dude, what the hell has this been the whole time? High-end talent bailed you out of certain destruction and Toronto cheated certain death. I'd be amazed, but I'm more pissed at them. How about you play up to your fucking potential for once? Do it, please. I'd love it if you went on a deep run with this momentum. What the hell do you mean you responded by laying the biggest egg in franchise history? You lost? You have all of that forward talent and you don't even score a goal? What the fuck is wrong with you? Can you do something besides shit the bed in series-ending games? You know what? I'm done. The last time I ever pretend to care about this garbage heap of a franchise, I asked you to do one job and you can't even do that if it was chucked in front of you. Fuck off! 53 years of failure and counting. It's all on display for everyone to see. The terrible trades, the awful free agent signings, the playoff futility, fucking Boston. All of it concocted in this almanac of futility and repeated ineptitude on and off the ice. Even for all the hopes and dreams of Torontonians, they were repeatedly shot to hell and back with a serenade of bad goals and high sticks. The only time they've gotten anywhere close to the Stanley Cup was a god-awful excuse for a comedy that single-handedly ruined Mike Myers' career. During this time, a baseball, basketball, and soccer franchise have all been founded in Toronto. And they've won championships in their respective leagues. It's worthy of all the scorn of Canada and abroad. After watching this, you may be asking yourself, why? Why invest all this time and effort into a team that enjoys nothing more than smelling their own farts every April? That is simple. The Harold Ballard era is absolutely fascinating to me. If you glance at all the shit he's done over his reign, it doesn't even seem real. It feels like I'm looking at the script for a comedy with his shenanigans in the Carlton cash box. And I didn't even crack the surface of most of his antics. There's an entire chapter of this bullshit with the Hamilton Tiger Cats at the CFL, which he also ran like a circus. Hell, the fucker put the Tiger Cats logo on center ice of Maple Leaf Gardens! And fact, you can trace a lot of different issues to him. How team ownership would kill firstborn sons for profit, the ridiculously high ticket prices at Scotiabank, the frequency of how Leafs fans travel to road games, the willingness of the fanbase to put up with the propensity of horseshit. It's all because of the Ballard era. He was as insane as advertised, and I can only hope he's getting sodomized with stacks of $100 bills in hell. As for the current iteration of the Leafs, there was a time where I thought that this would be over for them, but after the past few seasons, I honestly don't know. Despite the pledge to turn a new leaf and avoid the errors of the past, I fear they've made a grave mistake locking up the forward core to that steep of a cap hit. Especially since, thanks to the pandemic, the salary cap will be staying at the same rate once again. The Leafs, like last year, are heading into a cap crunch that will force them to shed more talents. Let alone force them to take a deep look at how the team is constructed. Firing Babcock did nothing to fix it. The Shannon plan has hit a massive roadblock and it will take a Herculean effort to overcome it. Although I will say this. I will give this current regime props for mending broken relationships with the heroes of Leafs past. I'm looking directly at Dave Keon. With what Ballard did to him, it was a deep wound. And mending it after all this time is good to see. Finally retiring the numbers of Toronto's legends, even the catnip that is Wendell Clark. Another positive. I wish I could say the same for the product on the ice, but I'm having more and more questions as time goes on. Is Frederik Andersen the guy moving forward? Will they have enough cap to re-sign Morgan Riley? How long until the fanbase turns on John Tavares? What are they going to do about the defense with such limited cap flexibility? True, it's still a better product than most of the shit they put out over this half-century span, but in all seriousness, if you don't win a cup in the next decade, just delete your franchise. Again? Dear God. We traded this year's first-round pick to Carolina to shed the final year of Patrick Marleau's contract? Are you fucking kidding me? The Leafs are so inept that even their lottery balls are hitting the post. It's so fitting of this franchise. Golden opportunities undone by their own self-destruction.
And I don't think I'm any different here than I Ned, I told you not to ring this phone. Who? Oh, is he on the line? Okay, excuse me. How are you? Did you phone Clance? What's the matter with him? Yeah. And it's bad, too, you know. It's bad. But make sure he comes in, that's the thing. Okay, thanks. All right, Doctor.